My name is Vanessa Horn, and I am so excited for those of you who are joining us. I see Cassandra, I see Nicola, I see some others of you coming on live. Can you hear me and can you see me? Just to confirm that we have a clear audio and visual check. Just doing a quick check before we go live. I am so excited to see you guys. Let's see that we're not having any issues. And share this Facebook Live if it would benefit somebody you know around two things, because this is what we're going to be talking about on today's Facebook Live. One, if you have a passion, a skill set, an expertise, and you're wondering, can I really make money from it online? You're going to be learning how to actually package that expertise and passion and love that you may have into something that is monetizable online in the work that I do with my clients. And you're going to be hearing from Jeana, my guest speaker today, exactly what core marketing assets do you need to turn that passion, that idea, that love that you have into something that actually creates clients for you. So you're getting two subjects for the price of one on today's Facebook Live. And it sounds awesome. It looks like we got it clear on the audio and the visual. So allow me just to do a quick setup for you on exactly what we're going to be covering today, as I am super excited to share this information with you. My name is Vanessa Horn, and I am the creator of a program called Create Your Signature Program. And what I do is I work with passion-driven entrepreneurs, individuals who have a desire to serve others with their life story or with their expertise. And what I do is I help them package their expertise into something that they can sell online via an online coaching or training program. So today I've invited one of my clients and a colleague, a woman I deeply respect, to come on here to share exactly the process we went through and for you to hear about the program she created that comes all from her zone of genius and something that she's extraordinarily exceptional at and maybe like you was overlooking the value of what she did best. The stuff that came so easily for her was actually her zone of genius. And this is what I've discovered to be the case with multi-passionate, purpose-driven entrepreneurs like you and I. We overlook our genius. So today we're going to be talking about Jeana. We're going to be talking about how she was overlooking her genius and once she was able to dial that in, exactly how we packaged that into something that she could market online. And you're going to hear about her program. And when we go through that, you'll hear exactly what is a marketing funnel. And if you do want to monetize your gifts online, why it's the smartest thing that you can put into place. Even more valuable than a website, believe it or not. This is more valuable than a website. So when people say, Vanessa, I want to make money online, where do I start? I actually have them start with the core assets that Jeana is going to walk you through today. And then you're going to hear a little bit more about how you could take it further in packaging your expertise and passion into something you can monetize online through my program called Create Your Signature Program. Or if you have a desire in getting your marketing assets online and want to know exactly how you can get support around that with Jeana, we'll share with you where you can take it further. So with that, I want to welcome those of you who are on our Facebook Live. And I want to ask you a question. Do you already have something that you're marketing online, or do you have an idea? Do you have a passion? Do you have work that you want to get out on a broader scale? So which of those do you fall into? One, you're already marketing yourself online and you want to learn how to do it more effectively, or two, you're just in an ideation stage. You're playing around with ideas and you're considering, is this really something that I could do successfully? So I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And for those of you who do watch this replay after the fact, do know that Jeana and I will go back and comment on your comments and reply to you. So we do encourage you to be interactive in today's Facebook Live, whether you're watching us live or via the replay. It's our heart to serve you with this information because it comes from us having navigated how to be able to market ourselves online. And now it's our passion to serve you so that you can do the same. Awesome. So I see some of you are already marketing yourselves. Some of you are considering ideas. So we have a mix of a little bit of both. So allow me to introduce to you my guest speaker today on the Signature Series interview. And we call it Signature because I believe each one of us was born with a unique mark that we're here to make on the earth. And as unique as is your signature or your penmanship, is the unique mark that you're here to make. And so this guest is somebody who worked with me in my program called Create Your Signature Program in our Signature Series. And she was able to come in with these multi-passionate gifts and different things that she was doing in her business. She already had a successful business, but one of the things that I teach is laser focus in so that you can scale your business with greater ease. And so Jeana, whom you're going to get to meet today, was one of my clients in that program, and she is masterful at marketing online and the technology to be able to pull it off seamlessly. And so with that, I want to introduce you to Jeana DeShazer. Hi, Jeana. You want to say hi to the audience?
Hi, Vanessa. So happy to be here.
And Jeana is in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. We're really close to where my husband and I met in Tulsa, Oklahoma. So it's like, wait, Jeana, you're in Broken Arrow. So here in the middle of Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, you're making a difference in the lives and businesses of clients all over the world. So Jeana, why don't you share a little bit about what was going on for you before you came into working with me in Signature, in specifically in Create Your Signature program?
Okay, sure. Well, I have been in the technology industry for the past 25 years, and so technology was always so easy for me. I loved it. Anything that new came out, I always wanted to figure it out. And so then I got into the marketing industry and loved that too, and saw how I could mix both of them together. And so about 4 years ago, I became really interested in the virtual assisting area so that I could help people all over, not just in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. And so I started a virtual assisting business and very profitable at it and had several clients. But as time went on, I realized I didn't like doing everything. There was just certain parts that I liked, but I just couldn't figure out how to get it all together. So I was just out there doing whatever. Yeah, sure, I can do that. I can do that. I can do that. And I wasn't happy. I mean, I loved my clients and I loved what I was doing, but I wasn't truly in my happy place. And so I knew I wanted to get there. And do you want to tell how I met you?
Yeah.
Okay. So, I'm a webinar junkie, as most of us are, or some of us are anyway, always looking to hear something else that I can learn. I'm a perpetual learner, and I think there's something else out there I got to do to make all this click. And so I really don't even know how I found Vanessa's webinar. I do not. But I did, thank goodness. And gosh, from the beginning, I just knew that, I mean, I loved the way she spoke. I knew she was genuine. I knew she wasn't just another guru trying to take your dollar for something. I could tell she was genuine. And so I decided that I was going to listen and really listen intently. And she does these things called love seats, not hot seats. They're love seats. And she asked for a volunteer. And of course, I jumped on it because I thought if she can help me in my scrambled up mind as to what it is that I need to do, then I was in. I was her favorite student. And she did. She asked me some questions during that. I can't remember what they all were, but I know it brought in clarity in my mind as to what it was I needed to do. And most of that was the fact that I was dismissing that piece that a lot of people need, because I just thought everyone knew how to do it. Because it came so easy to me, the technology piece, I didn't, people would ask me how to do something. I'm like, really? You don't know how to do that? But it's reality. Not everyone is technical. And so of her asking me those questions, it became evident that I was just ignoring what it was that I needed to be doing.
So. Yeah. And I want to point that out for the audience, for those of you who are watching, that you probably are like Jeana. And we're going to dive into the specifics of her program so that you can hear exactly how a marketing funnel could serve you. But if you're wondering, okay, what do I use one of these marketing funnels for, or how do I optimize what I am creating online? I'm a huge proponent that if we focus in on our zone of genius, and we eliminate everything else, that is where our highest level of profitability is. But just like Jeana, we easily overlook what is our zone of genius, because it feels so easy. Here, Jeana had been teaching in university settings about technology. Here she was serving her clients around technology, but she had a bunch of different ideas. And Jeana, I know you and I have spoken about the fact when people would say, well, what do? You're like, well, kind of a whole bunch of different stuff. And so it didn't allow you to laser in on really scaling what you do best. And some of the questions that I do ask, and I probably did ask you on that webinar where you showed up live, it was asking the question of, these are kind of things that I ask to help my clients get clarity on their zone of genius, is if you and I sat in a coffee shop and I asked you a how-to question, what is something that would just boom, 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 come out of you without you having to look at your notes, without you having to research or study anything else? It just like would flow out of you. You'd be like, oh, step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is what you need to do. That's a clue to your zone of genius. Usually something that you have figured out, spent time figuring out. And it could be something as tangible as what Jeana does, which is online technology, so that your marketing is effective for you. Or maybe something like you've learned how to deal with the inner critic in your life so that you actually live your full potential. Well, people want those types of things. And so that's one little question that I ask. The other is, if we were in a car driving cross country, how would my life be different by spending 6 hours with you? How would I be impacted by you? And one of the things that you're going to experience about Jeana, which is so clear, is that she has this passionate heart to help others. And she also has an immense amount of patience. So those of us who are overwhelmed by technology and those of us who are like, do I really have to do this? She's able to break it down. She has a skill set that breaks down complex subjects into easy, doable, implementable steps. Well, that's a huge, huge genius that she was overlooking. And so all that we did in Create Your Signature Program was to bring all those things. And there's other questions that we dive into around zone of genius, but we focus on what do you love? What is your zone of genius? And then how do we turn that into, how do we determine the sweet spot of where those intersect with something that the market is willing to pay you for? And so I know, Jeana, that's probably what we talked about on that webinar, is pulling all those things together into how do you take all these different disconnected ideas or multi-passionate different things that you're good at. And my philosophy being one program could get you to $1 million. One program with multiple streams of income is the easiest way to leverage your time and your skill set. So I would love for you to dive into, let's dive into this subject of online marketing funnels. And your program is called Online Marketing SOS. And tell us what the tagline is, because I think it so tells us effectively what the program is about.
Yes, it's experience creating your funnel, completing your funnel to attract your ideal client.
So let's talk about that, because some people that are on here know what a marketing funnel is. Some people don't. And if you're in the watching us, put into the comments, are you familiar with what a marketing funnel is? Yes or no? Because we're going to break this down. So Jeana, how do you describe a marketing funnel?
Well, I look at a funnel as being kind of like a blueprint of where you are now and where you need to go. One of the first things I ask people when they come to me is, what do you want to, you know, what do you want to do? What's your end result? You know, where are you going? Where do you want to take this? And then we kind of work backwards from there to set it all up. But a marketing funnel is just, is basically, it's more than just, you know, some people think, oh, it's just some lead pages and some emails. And to me, it's more than that. I look at it as the whole process used to gather your ideal clients and take them through the process of becoming your client. So, you know, some people see things differently and call them different things, but I see it as the entire marketing piece of getting your statement out to your ideal client.
So in essence, finding those people who could be your ideal client. So right now they're at the prospect stage and converting them into a paying client. So they're actually being served by your work. So you leverage technology to do that process.
Right.
Through a marketing funnel. And it's interesting. I just had somebody who sent me their page, their online assets. And I said, okay, so if somebody's ready to work with you, where do you send them? Or somebody's interested in your work, where do you send them? And they sent me to, which is a common mistake I think people do, is they sent, she sent me her website. Well, when I went on her website, it was all about her passions, about her. Well, most people, unfortunately, or fortunately, it's human psychology, they're interested in, well, what about me? Mm-hmm. They land on your site and they want to know, how can you benefit me? How can you help me? What is your zone of genius? Mm-hmm. And so I landed on her site. There was no free gift, which would be a potential marketing funnel. There was nowhere to learn more about her services, nowhere to download anything, no webinar to watch. Nothing that would actually get me closer to getting her, having her as hiring her, except mm-hmm. like there was a contact page. And you help put those marketing funnels in place where, like on my site, it says free webinar, or here, mm-hmm. download this if you want to stand out in your industry and create money from your gifts. And so those are the beginning of marketing funnels. Why don't you share some of the other key mistakes that you see people make that prevent them from actually creating clients from what they're doing, trying to put their work out online?
Sure. Well, that obviously was a great example of not sending people somewhere that they can get clarity about what you do. And to me, that's one of the things you taught me, but that's one of the biggest things you have to do. You have to be clear about what you do and how you can help your ideal client. And if you're not clear on that, then someone coming to you is not going to be clear on it. So having a landing page that goes directly to what it is that you are going to help them with and what you're going to do, it to me is vital to going ahead and getting them. I mean, of course, from there, there's you know, the nurture sequence and the getting people to know you. To me, it's more like a relationship. Getting to know somebody. I don't necessarily like those that, you know, we've all opted in for stuff and instantly you're just bombarded with these emails about, you know, buy this, do that. And you know, to me, I want to know the person like you. I mean, it was easy to get to know you and know you're genuine and that you know what you're doing. And so, that's what it's about with me a lot is relationship. From the landing page, then you've got, there's many other things you can do with the emails and then getting them into, I'm just lost. I got sidetracked here watching the things pop up on the screen. Those shiny objects.
You're doing a great job. You're doing a great job.
You know? Those shiny objects that keep popping up, you know. The question was mistakes that people make, and shiny objects is one of them that I have written down that people get so sidetracked with the next thing that comes out, the next thing, oh, I'm going to buy that and I'm going to do that. And it's all going to work. And then they have all this stuff and they're frustrated. I know that's where I was at. I was frustrated because I have all these tools and none of them are fitting together. And so when I stepped back and could see that, oh, I only need two or three things here to really make this work.
Two or three things for the benefit of our audience? What are those core two or three things that they need that they can build everything else on, like the bright shining objects of do this online, do social media, do blogging, do Facebook Lives, do this? Yeah. What are those two to three things that they have to have that all the rest of that can layer on top of?
Well, I I'm in agreement with you. I mean, I think websites are important, but I think for a detailed, focused deal program, that a landing page is number one, that to bring people to. Okay, so you would need a program that creates that, whether it's lead pages or, you know, your click funnels or whatever. There's a lot of them out there. And
this is what you do in your program, right? Like, you help them navigate all those.
Yes. And I help them figure out, because some of them are like over the top. You don't need that, you know? And, you know, you've heard people say, oh, use this, use this, use this. And so you jump in there and then it's just so overwhelming. It can be as simple as just one page. You know, you don't need, I don't want to diss any programs because there's a lot of good programs out there, but I help them decide what it is they need. The next thing you need is like a CRM, which is an email where you keep your lists and stuff. And you can go with MailChimp. I mean, MailChimp is simple. Infusionsoft is up here. Not everyone needs Infusionsoft. I use it with several clients, but oh my gosh, it's such a huge program. You don't need it. So there again, I help people dial into what they really need. And between that and being able to have something to send emails to, out from, honestly, you could do it from there. A calendar program. Calendly is very simple. It's free. It integrates with your Gmail. I mean, there's so many little simple things that and cheap that you could get your marketing funnel up and going. And then once you get going and get a big list and you start generating, then yeah, we can move up to something bigger. And so that's what I help them realize that. You talked about lead magnets. A lot of people don't know what a lead magnet is, or if they do, they don't know what to give. You know, I've seen people give huge things. And to me, that's not a lead magnet. It's something that's simple and concise and that people can easily see from it that you know what you're doing. It's just a piece of information. It's not your entire program. It's not a book. It's mm-hmm. a checklist. It's a, you know, tips. It's just small things that people
can win.
An immediate win people can quickly consume. And I like them to be visually appealing. I mean, you know, just to have 10 tips and you just says 1, 2, 3, 4, it to me is not, because I want something, if it's meaningful to me, I'm probably going to print it out and have it there, you know, to refer to. So
I found this, you know, when I was in network marketing, I used to be in the network marketing industry before working online and helping people to create their online brands and programs. And I used to describe it like a baseball diamond. And people want to go immediately from, like, you know, being in front of their ideal prospect to closing them. Mm-hmm. And I would describe that the close or the invitation to working together is really like third base. And piquing interest and getting them to take a peek is first base. And second base is them really taking a deeper look at and, you know, where they may spend a little bit more time exploring or watching a webinar or doing something that exposes them more to how you can serve them. Then you can take them to third base. And then for me, home base is always like, can I get my prospect or my first client, can I get my client to have a win immediately? That's a home run for me, is helping my client have a win. And I think what I've observed in this online space is, in order for us to take a prospect to first, second, third, and home base, those first and second bases are really served by online assets. So by the time I get on the phone with a prospect or even somebody on my team, I already know that they've been exposed to how I can help them. They've been exposed to my marketing materials that helps them know they're in the right place and helps me know that I'm spending my time with somebody that is best served by my work. And leveraging online assets the way you've described with the funnel is what helps prospects go from taking a peek at first base to learning more at second base to then saying, yes, I want to work with you and becoming a client. And it's one of the most smart and leveraged things that anybody who's an entrepreneur or marketing themselves online is using these resources. I know that we've supported clients in creating their online marketing funnels. We call it an elegant marketing system. And most of the time, entrepreneurs would get caught up in and stuck on the tech stuff. And, you know, here I am supporting them in identifying what's their zone of genius, what are they best at, and let's help you be freed up to do that with the majority of your time. And I love that somebody like you, who is good at the tech, that can break down what is potentially complex and not our zone of genius into something that doesn't prevent our work from being out in the world. If we work with someone like you, we're getting those assets in place that once they're up, we just can send traffic there. We can really just now, and I believe personally that our marketing can serve others. Our marketing can be done in such a way that we can, I mean, personally, I prefer to give away what some people may charge for just in my marketing materials. It's my way of serving. And what your technology mindset helps someone like me and those who are watching accomplish is, let's not stay the greatest secret. Let's not stay in our home offices or even in our minds with our ideas. Let's leverage it through the platform of online marketing. So why don't you share, because I know this is something that we worked on together, which is, how do you take your expertise, something that you're good at, and then package it into a program? And when we talk about this, I want you to share what is included when somebody does work with you. How did you determine how many coaching calls it was going to be, or what was going to be included in your coaching program, or how to structure it? Because this is something you and I work together on and create your signature program. But that'll give those who are watching a clear idea of what are those core marketing assets that they need, because those are the core outcomes of your program. And then how did you structure it to ensure that your clients are getting those outcomes?
That was probably once I figured out my 10, as you call it, what it was I was going to focus on, that became my next roadblock, my mental stopping point, because I looked at your program and I thought, well, it's easy for her to do this. I can't do it. You know, instantly, it's amazing how instantly we want to write things off because we're not clear on them. And so, So that's when I jumped in there and said, you show me how this can be a program. Kind of like, go ahead, try it. I know you can't.
Not me. I'm the exception, Vanessa. I remember you in that webinar. You're like, not me.
Yeah, you can't do this. Yeah, because because a lot of people just do services, like they do strategic planning and stuff, and not that that's anything bad, but I was doing more of a technical piece, a actual doing it, implement. I'm the implementer. You know, I kind of came to this because I saw so many people get coaches and consultants and all that and paying big money to tell them what they needed to do. And then they would be so confused. They would call me and go, well, she told me I have to do this, this, and this. And I just don't know what, you know, I don't know how to do that. And they're so confused by it. And so that's when I said, I need to be the how to the strategic person's what, and help them implement that and basically hold their hand through the process. So anyway, to back it up, you just very simply said, well, here's how you do it. You're going to, you know, you can do a workshop or a masterclass, whatever you want to call it, and take them through it step by step. Tell me the steps it takes to get through that. Just as if you were talking to one person, you can do that to five or six, you know. And so that's kind of where I started, and then it kind of started clicking. Well, yeah, if I talk to someone and they call me and say, okay, how do we do this? Then step by step, first of all, like I said, we go through the discovery session or whatever, we figure out where they are right now. You know, what has worked for them and what hasn't worked, and why it didn't work if it didn't work. And we figure out those pieces, okay? And then from there, we take it on to the next step, which is, okay, so I said, we go to the end and here's what your end result is. We come back here and we start creating that, I teach them more, almost the language. I had one person tell me that it was like learning a new language, because I didn't get what's a funnel, what's a segment, what's it, you know, you talk about campaigns, you talk about, you know, landing pages, opt-in pages, sales pages. I mean, they all are the same, but they're a little different, you know? And so they just get so overwhelmed. So we go through all that, all the verbiage of what it is. And then I take them through a lead magnet, you know, what is a lead magnet, what is the best forms, and what would be good for you. So I help them individually. That's why I keep the class small. And I got to say, I love that class atmosphere with you. At first, there again, I'm a very skeptical kind of person because I thought, right, she's going to have us on there. We're just going to listen to her. We're not going to get anything done because there's going to be all these people on there. And it was so good because you're in an atmosphere of everyone's the same spot. You know, they have different programs, but we were all in the same spot, you know, and the same thing with mine. The people that come into my program are all in the same place. They need help with their funnel. It might be different. And so listening to everyone else's ideas kind of piqued my interest. And I'd go, oh, okay, I hear that. I can make that in mind, because there were people and they're going, I need what you've got. And they were giving me ideas. And so having that group atmosphere really helps. So anyway, so then we go through the lead magnet and we create it. It's not just, I'm not just telling it to you. We create it. So one day we talk about it and we have Q&A, and then we come back another day in that week. And it's like a workshop. If you need help, log on. I'm there. And we're going to walk through it. We're going to go through the program that you're in. And we're going to walk through it. And so we do that each week, you know, the lead magnet. Then we go through your emails and how to set them up, how many to send out. I mean, and to me, that's different for different markets. You know, what do they say? You need to be in front of someone like 3 times before it registers or something like that. I mean, there's a science to it. But anyway, you got to listen to your clients and your ideal clients, in my opinion. But anyway, so we go from there, and we go through setting it up, connecting it with your list in, say, MailChimp or Active Campaign, whatever it is you've got. And that's another week. We do that, and it just keeps building on it. And by week 6, that's the week where here it is, and we're all gonna look at your lead page. We're gonna walk through your funnel with you, as much as we can, you know, together, and get feedback and watch and make sure it works. I mean, how many times have I know I have hit something to go live, and then it was like, oh, that didn't work. That link's broke. And you got to go back and fix it. So at the end of the 6 weeks, you're not just going to walk away with a funnel that you can implement, but you're going to understand it. You're going to understand the concepts. And at the end of that time, there's sometimes people go, yeah, I get it now. I understand what we have to go through to get there, but I want nothing to do with it. So I want you to do it for me. And that's fine. We'll go into that phase also. But, or they might have someone on their team that they just want to hand it over to. And that's fine too. I want to teach them something that they can repeat. They can take this funnel and they can repeat it next time and not need my help or anyone else's help. So if you can go through this process one time and then rinse and repeat and do it again and again, it's totally worth the time spent with me to get through it.
Yeah, and that's one of the things that we walk through in Create Your Signature Program. Kathy's so sweet. Kathy said, love this info you're sharing, Jeana. That we talked about, whenever you are the type of person who does done for you services, this program that you've created is for the people who may not be able to afford your done for you, but this is a done with you option where you're supporting them alongside. And the immediate thing I've been able to see with my clients who do done for you services is they were able to increase the price of their done for you, because there was immediate value created by creating a program that, you know, is why I teach one program multiple streams of income, because you can have multiple price points where it's just like, okay, well, here's the info so you could do it yourself. Here's a group program that's at a mid-range price point that is, I'll do it with you. And then if you're like, nah, I don't want to do it myself at all, Jeana, will you do it for me? You have your premium done for you services, and it allows you for clients to choose which price point is the right price point and how do they prefer. Mm-hmm. They do it themselves, do it with you, or have it done for you. And so
I think one of the misconceptions though of the done for you, and I don't want to scare anyone off, is that you still have to be involved in the process. You know, I still need help in knowing, you know, what it is you're trying to do. It's not like you're just going to go, oh, I want to sell this, go do it for me. And I'll be honest with you, I lost a client once because he thought that, well, I'm paying you, why should I, you know, call me when it's done kind of a deal. And I still need that interaction with you. You know, it's,
well, especially someone like you who cares about them getting the outcome that they want. Right. Because there are people who would take their money and say, okay, I'll do it for you. But then it's a disconnected message. It's not really connected to the outcome. But like you described, mm-hmm. you say, where are we going? And let's reverse engineer this together. And then you help implement that. And it just it magnifies that you're one of these people who really care
right.
about
do.
The results really that they're going to get.
I do. And yeah, I think this has helped more people realize what all goes into it than I ever expected. You know, I had a client who once she sat there and watched me go through all this. I mean, I was with her on a VIP day and we just spent a whole day on a whiteboard drawing it out. You know, where are we going from here? We're going to go here and here. And she finally was like, oh my gosh, now I see what all goes into this. Mm-hmm. And before that, she didn't have a clue. She was just like, what's the problem? I mean, why can't you just do this? You know?
Well, and that's, you know, that's one of the things that somebody might be asking, like, oh, this seems like a lot. Or I know a lot of people like who are passion driven and have work that they want to get out in the world. They're just like, can I just do my work? Like, do I have to mess with that stuff? Mm-hmm. Like, what makes messing with that stuff worth it to me is the fact that one, it's leveraged. So now I'm not having to send out manual emails. Like I have a whole system that's working 24/7 on my behalf. Number two, it's serving clients. It's leveraging my time by serving them with the marketing materials. It's allowing me to increase the megaphone of my work in the world because it's not, I remember when I became a coach for the first time, I was like, I'm in my 10 by 10 office and nobody, it's not enough to ask somebody, how can I serve you? That's what I was taught when I first learned how to become a coach was you ask somebody, how may I serve you? And then you serve them. But the thing is that I consider it's of service to our audience to say, this is what I am best at. Mm-hmm. If you're struggling with this, I can help. And with the billions of websites that are up every single day, all the noise, it's online. Mm-hmm. It's an actual act of love to be able to filter through and say, not put the burden on the prospect to figure out how we can serve them, but to say, listen, if you're staying up at night, like in your case, thinking, how can I get my message out in the world in a bigger way? And I'm struggling with technology, Jeana's solution. If you're staying up at night and saying, my coach has told me what to do, but I don't know how to do the tech stuff, it's eating my lunch, then that's what your service. So you're saying, listen, if this is what you're struggling with and this is what's keeping you up at night, or this is what's preventing you from getting your work out in the world and serving more clients, I'm here to help. You're a sigh of relief when people come to you and they identify, oh, I can do it myself with your training. I could do it with you, or you could do it for me. I am so happy you're in my life. Like that's the way you're able to serve clients and you are leveraging online technology to do that. And so I love when you explain what you do in your program over the 6 weeks because it's a great checklist for those who are listening to the Facebook Live. Do you have these things in place? Number one, do you have that lead magnet? And that lead magnet, which is something that gives them a quick win, it gives them exposure to how you can serve them. And I'll just give you an example. I have one at, I think it's freesignatureblueprint.com. And that's like what we're talking about. Like you can see it tangibly if you're unfamiliar with what this is. It's basically my blueprint for how to put together a signature program. And if it's wrong, we'll correct it in the comments. But I think it's freesignatureblueprint.com. And it's like a checklist. It's my how-to technology-wise or how to identify your idea, how to package it, et cetera, and how to avoid the biggest mistakes. And it's a quick win. The other thing that you described, Jeana, was, do you have the email marketing emails in place? So I don't have to send that gift out. Once somebody goes there and provides their email, the system's automatically sending it to you. You talked about being able to test it end to end to make sure that it's working and setting up that thank you page in place and all of those technologies intertwine working together seamlessly. And so you help them go through. So if you're watching this today, do you have that in place right now? Do you have a way by which you can turn somebody who's completely cold? And you know, I want to emphasize that you said, Vanessa, when I watched your webinar, I knew that you cared and I knew that you knew your stuff. that's two things that were accomplished in marketing. One is what I call connection, and two, credibility. And that's what our online marketing assets do for us, is they accomplish connection and create credibility. And you can do that 100% authentically. You don't have to be a different person online than you are in person. Exactly. And you can share the essence of who you are through your marketing and leverage the online assets to do the work for you. So I want to transition at this time, Jeana, into sharing with our audience a little bit more about what was your experience in Create Your Signature program. And for those who do have an interest in speaking with you further about the technology stuff or about your program, where could they go? What's your domain that you would share with them as we transition to talking about what you did in Create Your Signature program?
Yes, it's onlinemarketingsos.net. Not .com, .net.
Safety net, you throw them out to them. So onlinemarketingsos.net, if you want to hear more about Jeana's services.
There's a link on there for my calendar. If you want to talk more about it, I'd love to talk to you. There's an email on there. So either way, email or talk, I'm there for you.
So let's talk about your experience in the virtual workshop that I run, Create Your Signature Program, and that's found at createyoursignatureprogram.com. And let's talk about a couple of the key things that some of those of you who are watching today may have struggled with. And that is, well, we talked a bit about how Jeana was multi-passionate, multi-talented, and how we dialed into what was her zone of genius. So we'll be sure to package that as what we were doing in her core program. But the second thing, Jeana, is, you know, we talked about you were discounting your zone of genius. And so therefore that affected the rates that you were confident in charging. Do you want to talk about how dialing in the clarity of your program and stepping into your zone of genius allowed you to increase your rates?
Sure. Yeah, that's always a touchy thing. No one wants to talk about the money, you know, but it's true that when you don't feel like what you're doing is that important, then you don't feel like you can charge for it. When I realized, talking to you and then talking to everyone else in the group and outside people, that this really is something that not everyone knows, because there again, when it's so easy to us, I don't want to say it's frustrating, because it's not, but you just sometimes think, really? Well, I can't believe that you would pay me for that. But when you realize that, and you realize that what you have is what someone else needs, and more than that, it's taking off of them. I mean, we kind of look at what will your life be like if you don't do this? You know, let's look at it differently. Let's not look at the money you're spending. Let's not look at the time you're spending. Let's look at what you're going to lose if you don't.
Yeah.
For example, the client I said a while ago I lost because he thought I was just going to take and do everything for him. I've checked back on him. He's exactly where he was 5 months ago when he didn't go ahead and take that step.
Yeah, so, how many clients are you losing by not having an online
marketing? Exactly. What are you losing by not doing this? And so that's kind of the way that's the way I looked at it with you. It was investment in time and money, but what was I losing by not doing it? That's the way I like to look at it. And what else did you want me to go into the program and tell more about it?
Yeah. So let me explain to the audience what we did together, because it's one of my programs that I have called Create Your Signature Program. And we do the work in a single day, mostly. Like, we have a little bit of, you get access to my online course, and we have some coaching calls to support you, but the majority of the work is done in a single day that we guarantee the outcomes. Why? Because I've done this workshop now 14 times, I believe. And I know that, Jeana, with you, we were inviting you, like, trust the process. Like, we promise. And let me just go over, like, what are the outcomes? Because one of the key things, like, with your work or anyone who's here to market themselves online, that people buy our outcomes. They don't buy number of coaching calls. They don't buy how many hours. They don't buy how many videos. They don't buy any of that. They buy outcomes. And that's why when you were sharing your outcomes, it was a great checklist for people to see, do they have these things in place? I do want to share the outcomes of our work that we guarantee, and it just happens to be delivered in a virtual workshop, because whenever I used to work with clients creating their programs, I would be astounded. I'd be like, wait, you've been working on your program for years on your own, or you've been taking 2 months to dial in your program or your offer. It doesn't have to take that long. Like, let's get your offer in place so that we can turn around and start creating clients right away, which is how I was able to compress what was normally done in 6 weeks down to a single day. And these are the, it's all outcome based. And it's one, and I want you to share your testimony around how this changed things for you. But number one, being able to confidently and succinctly answer the question, what do you do? Because if you can answer that, you can pique people's interest to get to first base. Mm-hmm. Number two, identify clearly whom you serve. And as you guys are listening to this, do this checklist in your own mind of how clear is your offer? How clear is what you're selling online? So identify whom you clearly serve. Number three, identify what problem you solve for them in a way that they understand. So there's no sense in just creating a program or just putting something online unless it solves a problem. Does it help your ideal audience get closer to what they want most? Number four, position to stand out. When there's so many websites up, there's so many people marketing to us, there's so many people, how are you going to stand out from everyone else? It's the clarity of how does your story, how does your unique offer stand out from everyone else? How is it different than what other people have to offer? Number five, naming your program. So you came up with the online marketing SOS, and your subtitle that is helps people be clear about what's the outcome of the program, the modules of your program, your pricing, your ascension model, which means you know exactly if that program's not the right fit, what's an upsell or downsell option for your prospect. Number nine, the delivery method. So one program can be turned into group programs. Group coaching programs can be turned into online information products or home studies. Number three, virtual workshops, speaking, books, and VIP days. These are all the income streams that I help my clients create from just one program. And then lastly, knowing how to enroll clients, specifically premium clients, because those are the clients whom are best served by work, get the best results, and allow us to be most profitable in our business. So those are the core outcomes. So let's just, as we wrap this up, why don't you share how you, that peak interest, just getting this, the peak interest statement down right for you, mm-hmm. of answering the question, what do you do, in a way that people understand. Why don't you share kind of what was your before the workshop experience and what has it been since? Like, what's been the benefit of you dialing in a peak interest statement? And then I'd love for you to share what your peak interest statement is.
Okay. Well, like I said earlier, beforehand, it was, I help everyone do everything. And that was not good. It was not getting me very far.
We think that we get more clients that way, and we don't. That does not work. That, you got to be specialized.
That's so different. That, and you know, you said something. It's harder to get a client for a low end product than it is to get one for a high end product. And that so blew me away. I'm like, really? That sounds so crazy. Why couldn't you get someone for $497? Easier than you can get some for $24.97, but it's true. So beforehand, it was just like, I serve everyone. I do anything for anybody. Afterwards, and let me say, this was like the best style of workshop that I've ever had, because I'm that kind of person that needs that structure and that we're going to do it. And you have 10 minutes, go away, come back, kind of a deal, and focus. Because if I'm on like a, you know, 6 months or whatever program or year long thing, I just get so sidetracked. And so this was great. This was a great format. So from there, I narrowed down who I served and what I did. And so my peak interest statement now, instead of I serve everyone and do everything, it came down to I help entrepreneurs who are overwhelmed and confused by the technology of online marketing. So that tells who I serve. It tells you instantly when you hear that overwhelmed and confused, it's like, yeah, that's me. I, you know, that hones in on which ones they are and what it is I do. I help them with the technology side of it.
So tell us this before the workshop was even done. People were reaching out to you on Facebook, and what was the effect of getting that little statement? And that I'll just point out, the biggest mistake people make is they speak too much instead of like one succinct sentence. So what was the benefit of you getting that dialed in for people who are reaching out to you?
Yes, I was in a Facebook group that I'm in, and someone asked a technical question about MailChimp, and I was able to fix it for her, answer her, and fix it for her within 5 minutes. And she was like, oh my gosh, what do you do? You seem real tech. You know, real techie. What do you do? Well, there you go. I was able to tell her in one sentence what I did, and instantly she got it and she understood it. And she was like, oh my gosh, I need you and all of my clients need you. Let me know when you get your program up and going. So that was just like confirmation to me that this is so much better than having this vast array of things that I do for people.
Yeah. Yay.
Yes.
Well, we are going to wrap up today's Facebook Live. Those of you who are on here, why don't you share in the comments, what was the biggest thing that you took away from watching today's Facebook Live, whether it was related to marketing your services online, like knowing how to package yourself, what are those key things that Jeana implemented that helped her? Maybe it was that, or maybe it's something that you learned about the online marketing funnels and its benefits to you, or maybe you identified something that you don't have that you need. And we want to give you two places where you can get some more information. Just to reiterate, Jeana's domain where you can learn more about her, you can go to onlinemarketingsos.net, onlinemarketingsos.net. And if you want my free blueprint on online programs, then go to freesignatureblueprint.com, free signature blueprint. And it'll basically walk you through what Jeana helps you set up, which is the gift and lead magnet, as she calls it, where you get the gift, and you can learn more about our upcoming Create Your Signature Program workshop to see if that's the right fit for you. If you don't want to just do this alone and you want somebody helping to draw out your zone of genius and to create a program that you can market online, that's what I'm doing, helping clients do coming up next month. Would love to have you in that. So thank you for those of you who are on here live, and thank you so much, Jeana, for sharing of yourself and your experience and of your program.
Thank you for having me on here.
All right. Lots of love. Beijos for now. Bye.